I got a photo of him standing in front of the tank.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool. And is that at home?
That's at home, yeah.
Can you say how long's the memorial been here for now?
Several years. Yeah, 15 years.
15. Yeah. Are the old ones going alright?
Yeah, really? Yeah, I know.
This day of remembrance, we are gathered here in gratitude for the sacrifice of those who died that we might live, for all who endured pain that we might know joy, for all who suffered imprisonment that we might know freedom, for all who fought on land, on sea, in the air, we pray that our deep feelings be turned into determination and our determination into deeds. As men and women died for peace, may we live and strive for peace. Let us pray. At the end of each prayer that follows, I shall say, in glad thanksgiving, will you respond, please, with, "We will remember them." Almighty God, We thank you today for all those who across the ages have been examples of courage, all whose words and actions have given inspiration to subsequent generations. In glad thanksgiving, we will remember them. We thank you for those who have had the courage to stand up for their convictions, come what may, to fight against evil and injustice, even at the cost of their own lives, to live out their faith and share it with others in the face of bitter opposition. In glad thanksgiving, we will remember them. Especially this day, we remember the sacrifices made in two world wars and in later conflicts to preserve peace both at home and abroad. We hold in our hearts and minds those, both military and civilian, who ranged under the Union flag, irrespective of their colour, class, nationality, or creed, and who displayed and continue to display such courage through all the horrors of war. Those who fought so bravely, who served so faithfully, and who sacrificed so greatly for the cause in which they believed. The cause of peace. In glad thanksgiving, we will remember them. We give thanks for the freedom we enjoy through their sacrifice. We salute their courage, we acknowledge again the debt we owe them. And we will remember and pray that the lessons of the past may not be forgotten or sacrifices wasted. In glad thanksgiving, we will remember them. Let us remember now in silence before God and commend to his sure keeping those whom we knew, those whose memory we treasure, all who have lived and died in the service of mankind.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Standard bearers, Larry, standard.
Thank you.
go home, tell them of us. For your tomorrow, we gave our today.
Falls the even tide.
Is there anyone else that would like to lay a wreath or a cross?
I'll do.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgiving for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of thy love, and bring us all with them to thine eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the blessing of the Lord rest and remain upon all his people in every land, of every tongue. The Lord meet in mercy all who seek him. The Lord comfort all who suffer and mourn. The Lord hasten his coming and give us, his people, the blessing of peace. Amen.
Before we close the service with the American Honour Guard and the National Anthem, I would like to invite Councillor Sam Chapman Allen to say a few words on behalf of the Desert Rats. Sir.
General Paul, County Chairman, Sir, Moms, ladies and gentlemen, and veterans. It's an absolute honour for me to be here this afternoon amongst such prestigious individuals. Breckland as a district has a mighty fine affiliation to the armed forces, whether it's those who have previously served or those who still serve. And of course, as a county, we're immensely proud of all of our military personnel. From the days of the Second World War, when the 7th Armoured Division, those famous Desert Rats, trained here in Thetford Forest and the surrounding areas, to the immense bases across the district and the Royal Air Force, and of course our training area, which is just behind us, and I was delighted that the Household Cavalry were able to come and join us also. We have a great affiliation to those who served, those who have previously served, and of course, your families. And I'd like to thank Lieutenant Colonel Simon Copley-Smith for inviting me here today and to meet so many of you who are involved with the Desert Rats. I did have something fantastic to say for our young cadet forces about being the next generation and how fantastic it would have been to see them. But sadly, once again, COVID has put a stop to that. But I do hope all of you will join me in looking forward to the future as the pressures on COVID, that dreaded word, come to an end for our country. And I've been asked to say a vote of thanks to all of those who are involved in the National Health Service, who have delivered an outstanding service in tremendous odds. But I'd also like to salute those service personnel who have been supporting the National Health Service throughout the pandemic, whether it's supporting in hospitals, delivering primary care, or the vaccine rollout, which has been incredible. And it's been an important part every single one of our service personnel has played. The forces as a whole has played an incredible debt to our nation globally, and we should all have a big vote of thanks to everybody who has served and is willing to continue to serve. And as we stand here today, surrounded by this incredible memorial, surrounded by incredible memories, and remembering those who are sadly no longer with us, I think all of us should reflect on what has been a really challenging 18 months. A young man such as myself, I will have no appreciation of what it was like to live through the Second World War. But I'm sure through that period, some of us were able to reflect on some of the challenging circumstances and the personal contributions every single one of us has made, small and large. We must never forget the sacrifices made and the sacrifices individuals are willing to continue to make in the name of our country and serve in the armed forces. Simon, thank you ever so much for allowing me to be here today. And the final part, I'm really honoured to be able to do three presentations. The first presentations are to Fred and Morris. I'm afraid, gentlemen, you're not going to get away that easily. Fred and Morris, throughout the last couple of years, have been complete stalwarts in fundraising thousands of pounds. And as a small token of everybody's thanks, we've got a presentation for them both. So the presentation is a tank link, track link, which has been made into a tank. It weighs a bloody ton.
I will shake hands. Are you happy to shake hands?
Yes, sir.
I've been naughty. Great.
It's an RTR tank. It's broken.
And being a politician, we are immensely boring, I'm not going to lie, but somebody's been hosting me today, Beverly Cooper, and thank you for putting up with me today, but more importantly, Beverly, you're not going to get away either. Beverly has raised tens of thousands of pounds, and a token of our appreciation, we'd like to present Beverly with a bouquet of flowers for her outstanding work to the armed forces, their families and their veterans.
Thank you very much, sir. We are coming to the end of our service, and in a minute I will raise my hat. This is an indication to the honour guard to mark directly through the crowd. So if you could please part like the Red Sea, not yet, when I raise my hat. Thank you. And then we will have the national anthem, and the service will be concluded.
Standard bearers, carry standard.
Thank you.
bit. Oh.
Please fall out for standards.
Band of bearers, fall out.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The stall stands are still open for another hour and a half. Please enjoy and obviously mind the household cavalry's present to us. Thank you.
It was right here.